Yeah, we're back.
Hey.
What's going on? We're rebels of YouTube. Right, Jax?
Yes, sir.
JC's here with us. JC, man. All right. Hey,
breaking all the rules.
Sorry about that, JC. You know, I mean, sometimes shit happens, man. We're live. You know, it's not pre-recorded. So when we get taken down for some sort of reason or something happens, there's a glitch, we have the opportunity to come back, and that way we can, you know, get back and tell you where we were at. And we were with JC, who's got some music out. It's put all his information on the screen so people can follow him, can go check out his music, stream it, put it on their playlist. Do you perform? Do you have a band that you tour with or you play with?
I've been using pickup bands recently. I'm in the process of putting a band together because I'm a solo singer. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it's easier to get a pickup band.
And what is a pickup band?
Is, for example, if someone hires me, like I just played in Dallas, you hire a band that is already in Dallas. Mm-hmm. And they get the music a couple of weeks ahead.
Yeah.
And then I just show up and they're there and we sing. And
yeah. Yeah.
I've done that.
Hired again. Guns.
Basically.
Yeah.
There's pros and cons to that. Sometimes they don't learn the music as good as you would like to because to them it's just a one-time gig.
Mm-hmm.
But it's also simpler than to have to take the whole band with you.
Simpler and less expensive, probably. Less expensive. Man. Yeah, man. That cabrón.
So,
and right now with diesel costs and all that and everything, man, everything's just... I feel for the musician and the artist, they had to stop playing in 2020 and lost a lot of revenue and struggled so much. And then when we've got to be able to go back up again, well, the gas goes up, everything goes up. And then So it's not more struggle. So, but we're still out there, man, entertaining people as much as we can whenever they want us, dude, right?
Yes, sir.
That's what we do, man.
Don't stop. Don't we're entertainers. Stop. Can't stop.
Yeah. You got on that stage in City Breeze with City Jam, and you lost your shyness there, bro. And you know, and then you just said, you know what, I'm going to do this. And you guys were good at what you did, man. I liked
it.
You
were amazing.
Yeah. And then you went off, and I like it that you try a lot of different, you explore. You explore and experiment. You did the music that's pop ballads, and then you did the reggaeton. And then you went into the Tejano, and so... Yeah.
For me, it's about the songwriting. As long as I get to write the music, that's what is most important to me. That's how I started. I just wanted to write some music.
Mm-hmm.
Everything else came afterwards. But with Tejano and with... I also have a Norteño song in that album. So with Tejano and Norteño, that's what I like.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's where I've gotten the best response. It's a genre that I really enjoy performing, and the people can also get up and dance.
Mm-hmm.
So it has that ambiguity about it that you can do sing my love songs, but people can also, they don't have to sit there, you know, and just enjoy a slow song. They can get up and dance to it.
Yeah. Make sure to check him out, ladies and gentlemen. JC, and we want to thank our sponsor, Don Juan Boots Breaking.
Woo!
Breaking, we got a new sponsor.
Hell yeah. Great boots.
Yeah, Don Juan Boots has been making custom-made boots, belts, and hats, and other leather goods for many, many years. Look at all the boots, man. I mean, he's got jingles of boots in there. They're beautiful. I love the way it smells in
Sorry,
there.
I was just going to say that.
Leather. I mean, Don Juan Boots is the best in the business. I personally have boots made by Don Juan, and I'm going to bring them. I'm going to show them to y'all. I've got an awesome biker boots made out of rattlesnake. I don't think anybody has one because every time I go bike riding, motorcycle riding, I run into motorcycle guys. Mm-hmm. They're like, where the hell did you get those? But I got them at Don Juan Boots. They have rattlesnake, boa, ostrich, caiman, crocodile, alligator, lizard, eel. They can even make special designs on your boots. I have some special made boots from Don Juan with the Whiskey D logo on them. And they're biker boots made out of snake as well.
Those are beautiful.
Yeah, man. And then you can go to their website, donjuanbootsonline.com, and they will mail them to you. They'll send them to you, all right?
Free shipping.
Free shipping.
There you go.
Okay. So you can follow Don Juan Boots at TikTok, Don Juan Boots RGV, Instagram at Don Juan Boots RGV, Facebook, Don Juan Boots USA, or contact them with any questions at 956-781-3194. Look at the designs for the cops. Did you see that?
Hello?
The Texas Ranger boots and
nice.
Texas DPS boots and those snakes. Look at those, man.
Whoa.
He made that. It's all Texas. I wanted to buy them, bro. They're freaking awesome. Awesome, dude.
Wow.
Look at this. Got the seal.
He got a lot of good stuff.
Yeah, and then he's got that design in the back, that black boots. Ladies and gentlemen, this guy delivers nationwide and all over Texas. Don Juan Boots is located 607 West Interstate 2. That's Expressway 83 here in Far Texas. And if you mention hashtag PVT, Don Juan's going to give you an automatic discount on everything.
You know all what? Right. I'm going to use that discount and my Chad Zone Keeper hashtag PVT powers to go get a discount. Y le voy a decir a Don Juan, can you make me some Jordan boots? Because, man, I would love some Jordan boots.
Imagine.
Like, dude, jingle bling, como dijo Mayito Tams over here.
Bro, he'll do them, bro.
I know. He will do them. I want that.
And he'll make them. You go in there, he'll check your foot out and, you know, measure it.
Le voy a decir que me ponga la little check mark.
Double stitching, papa. No me cállate la boca. Chat up.
Man, I just want to thank everybody in the chat zone for sticking with us because we had a little glitch there, but they came, they stayed with us and they're loyal and you know, I just want to give them a shout out real quick. Sal in the house, Krabby, you know, the regulars, man, they stayed with us and they're loyal and they are ride or die. Lisa R, thank you. Sal in the house, Mayito Tams, Johnny Borges, who am I missing? Victoria Garcia, thank you for joining us. Lisa R, Bobby Hernandez, thank you, and shout out to all the Packers fans. Ivan Cardona from Brooklyn, Noe Garza, Tejano Music Lover, shout out. Roel Ibarra, yes, you do get your first hashtag PBT shout out, thank you. Woo! M Garza from watching us from San Diego, thank you. And Luis Osuna, you get your shout out too.
Orale. Wow, that's awesome, man. We got people all over the nation. Ladies and gentlemen, make sure to go to your online, your music streaming service, and you look up JC, Y-E-I-S-I, and start streaming some of his jams, man. He's got some great music, and is a well-rounded musician and artist. And I was going to ask you, JC, when you say you write the songs, is it just the lyrics, or you actually can write the music, you know, like, you know, because I saw Buddy Holly, the movie, and I didn't realize that he would actually write the notes and write the movie the music on music sheets. Is that the way you do it, or do you play piano or anything like that?
I write it with the piano and the guitar. I have written a few things, like the notes, the staff.
Uh-huh.
But honestly, a lot of musicians don't read music.
No, dude. So
it wouldn't do any good to me to write it out for them.
¿Tú sabes a leer música, Jax?
Mi madre.
¿Y toca la guitarra con madre este vato, bro?
All I do is puro oído. And, like, yes, I do study, like, the basic, you know, like, scales and stuff like Simone. That. Pero es puro oído, dad, al chile.
Yeah.
Like, a song that I did some years ago and had a cello part. So, for that, I wrote the cello part so I could have it there. Because it's kind of weird. For musicians that learn, you know, to read music, it's not so easy, at least for me, to freestyle like other musicians that can just pick it up and start playing it. Yeah. I'm used to seeing the music. Uh-huh. I look at the key signature, the time signature, and that's how my brain processes it.
Hey.
And I know musicians that'll pick up anything. So yeah, let me just hear it and I'll start playing right up.
I'll join in.
And unfortunately, that's not my how I work.
No, chica, that's how we work, no? Prende el primer pinche radio a todo algo, let's do it. You know, nomás que comienza un pinche beat o algo, vámonos recio.
Oh, my goodness.
I admire that of musicians that can just hear it and start playing off the back. That's not one of the things that I can do.
No, I would imagine that most musicians and artists that are really big time are like you. I mean, they have to see, you know, and do it right. And, you know, I mean, just freestyle it, cabrón, bro.
Well, one example, Paul McCartney doesn't read any music. Mm-hmm. And he said it many times, I can't read anything.
Oh, that's true. Paul McCartney can't read music.
Any music at all.
That's
true. He's never looked at a note or has no clue how to read music. And he can play anything. Piano, guitar, bass. Yeah. He can write it.
Pues es un don, bro. I mean, these guys, you know, they're savants, or what do they call that, man? Yeah. I mean, mm-hmm. to be able to create what they created during the Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band album. Yeah. Was way out there, man. In the 60s, dude. I love that song, the concept, the whole album.
I love his little,
I heard the news today, old boy.
About a man.
Yeah, dude, that's good stuff.
That's John Lennon, though.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. Oh, that's true. And apparently that song, a little bit of history, apparently that song, he wrote it because, I don't know if you've heard about the theory that Paul is dead.
Yeah.
And that song was written apparently like for Paul that he, you know, like that he died. I heard the news today that, you know, that this guy
on
died,
the white album
that he
they
died
were
in
saying,
the crash. They
well,
said
on the white album they said that it, you know, I remember I had a cassette back in the '80s, and if you would play it backwards, you would hear like a car crash and scream.
No. You know, he says I killed Paul. He
and
says
then on that. Abbey Road, they have they're walking across the street. And one of them's a priest, and one of them is a pallbearer, and I think Paul is there barefooted,
like
which means he's
the
guy.
Cemetery.
He's the guy in the box, exactly. And then Harrison's like the grave digger in the back.
You know your Beatles theory. Well, you his know, theories in history. Yeah, you know.
There's a lot of little different. And the Beatles were way ahead of their fucking time, bro.
Yeah, they were. I love the Beatles with a passion.
Yeah, dude. Yeah. We could talk about Beatles all fucking day, right? Dude?
Oh, yeah, especially with Yeezy here with us. He's a great big Beatles.
Huge Beatle fanatic.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, hell yeah.
Who's your favorite Beatle? Can you tell us who your favorite Beatle is?
Was Paul McCartney, carnal?
He's been mentioning Paul McCartney a lot, but like, you don't even know. Maybe he likes Sean.
Hombre, Paul McCartney era el mero mero.
I think just because Paul McCartney lived more, he has so much more music. Unfortunately, yes. John was cut very short. Well, and he didn't get a chance to do a lot.
When John was murdered, he had released an album that was probably Woman, It's So Hard to Explain, you know, that album, watching, I'm Just Watching the Wheels, and that was like his biggest, he was like on the, he was having some momentum to get there,
he had been
man.
Away from the studio, and he was actually very afraid to go back in the studio. He wasn't sure if he was still going to be relevant, and people that worked on that album, you know, have talked about how he was, he felt like he was starting again. Like, are people going to like what I do now? I've been out of the studio for a while.
I could imagine. Yeah. So, and then they're going to compare him to Paul and, you know, I mean, all that
exactly.
stuff.
Bro. I would say John, because he had such a short career, because his life was cut short. He does have some gems, though. Like, Imagine. It's hard to top a song like Imagine.
Yeah.
Just from the from the first piano chord. There's something about it.
Yeah.
And
I love Dream. Dream number 9, I think.
Dream number 9.
La da, gone away. La da 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 da. That song takes me back to 75, dude. Something like that, bro, man. But that song was really awesome. And then, the que tiene Ringo Starr. I said, no, I don't smoke it no more. I'm tired of waking up on the floor. You never heard that song?
I never heard that one. I think that wasn't with the Beatles, right? I think that was one of the ones that they just put in the refrigerator and told them, oh, nice song, and put it in the refrigerator.
It's the no-no song. Have you ever heard it, JC, the no-no song?
No.
I'm afraid to play it. They might cut us down, but I'll just tell them to mute it. But, man, you got to hear this song. This is Ringo Starr in the 70s. Listen to the lyrics, man. We'll talk through some of it until he starts singing. This song's great, bro.
I want to credit the Beatles.
I know just came from Colombia. She smiled because I did not understand. Then she held out some marijuana.
Oi?
She said it was the best in all the land.
But what did you say, Ringo?
And I said, no, I don't smoke it no more. Tired of waking up on the floor.
Oi.
No thank you please, it only makes me sneeze. Then it makes it hard to find the door.
Yeah, watch out. This is a great song, bro.
A woman that I know just came from Mallorca, Spain. She smiled because I did not understand. She held out a 10-pound bag of cocaine.
Oh,
she said
shit.
It was the finest in the land.
Now.
I said, no, I don't, no more. Up on the floor.
Dude, you gotta hear this song, bro. I don't wanna play too much of it, bro. Los Tumba Cardan. You hadn't heard this one, JC, from Ringo Starr?
No, Ringo is probably the one that I've listened to the least. I'm also a big George Harrison. I think George Harrison had a lot of great songs.
Yeah, well, that Christian, he was having a little Christian backlash because of a. The song My Sweet Lord. It was a Hare Krishna. It was another religion or something like that. Mm-hmm. Back in the day, that was one of his big
Isn't
hits.
Isn't it a pity?
Yeah.
Would you guys have you anytime?
Would you guys agree with me if I said that I credit the Beatles for creating cumbia? Would you guys agree with me? Have you guys ever heard the song Obladi Oblada?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's a cumbia.
Yeah.
It's a cumbia. I believe the bass line, that's the first cumbia ever made, I believe.
If you ask me, I would dare say that the Beatles' influence is in all music. Yes. I mean, in the 70s, you used to hear it more prevalent with ELO and, you know, Dave Mason and a lot of these. There was a band that Paul McCartney was also producing, and they were really awesome. Badfinger, I think, was their name. Mm-hmm. But you heard a lot of, you know, Alice Cooper. You heard a lot of the Beatles in songs. Mm-hmm. And then it kind of like it became unnoticeable later on in life. Well, but it's still in there, even in cumbias and shit like that.
In that interview you did with Gilbert, he says, you know, if it wasn't for the Beatles, you know, I wouldn't be here doing this. Mm-hmm. And that's because, you know, he's a Tejano, not in the genre of the Beatles at all. But I think everybody, whether they know it or not, were influenced by the Beatles.
I think we all have a little Beatles inside of us.
I just freaked out with their evolution from when they started in 63 till 70, man. The way they went from like those guys in the little suits and then all freaking beards and all hippies locals and shit. I mean, the whole transition in such a short time. A lot of times it's one decade they're like this, the next decade they're a little different, you know, they got to try to catch up to the times. But these guys just evolved right there in those, what, 7 years?
They were only together for 8 years.
Yeah.
Acid's a hell of a drug.
It's a short amount of time for the incredible amount of music. And they have gospel, they have folk, they have protest, they have acoustic, they have
Norwegian wood. I mean, these guys would try everything, right?
they love to experiment.
Yeah. No, the opposite. And then George Martin, man, the guy that dude was the producer, man. That dude was a genius, dude.
But you know who inspired the Beatles, right?
Well, Little Richard.
Little Richard, of course. I love Little Richard.
Yeah, this guy's trying to throw me some trivia.
You know your shit, right? Yeah. You're not rock and roll James for nothing.
JC, man, thanks for coming, bro. We appreciate you, all right?
Pleasure to be here with you guys. It was a blast, and hopefully your audience enjoyed it. So thank you for tuning in. Thank you very much.
Yeah, make sure to check out his song, Te Tuve, Te Perdí, and his new song, Reminiscencia.
Reminiscencia.
Man, my tongue is tight already, man. What the hell did Green Hit give me in this damn thing?
This thing has something.
Ladies and gentlemen, God bless you. Thank you for joining us. We'll be back next Wednesday. We have a pro bodybuilder that just came back from New York. So make sure to check us out.